I'm Troy Kirby with MLT News with a quick look at the 2021 Washington State legislative session. The Senate State Government and Elections Committee heard testimony on Engrossed Substitute House Bill 1078, which would restore voting rights to formerly incarcerated individuals convicted of a felony. The bill was passed by the House on February 24th via vote of 57-41 and would have to pass through the Senate in order to make it to the governor's office to become law.
This bill is also important to thousands of people across our state who are currently disenfranchised. Many of them are my personal friends. They are working, living with their families, giving back to their communities and supporting others, paying taxes, and fighting every single day through the stigma of being a person with a felony conviction in securing housing, employment, professional licenses, or even volunteering in their children's school.
From my perspective and how I've grown up, on the streets, you know, there's that phrase, you kind of grow up as an army brat, you know, you move around a lot. I grew up as an AA brat. My mom, fortunately, took to sobriety early in life. And so I grew up in a lot of AA halls watching people try to come out of a life that they wanted to leave behind and start afresh. And one of the common things that I learned was that there are 1,000 ways. We have that phrase in the house, there's 1,000 ways for bills to die. Well, there's 1,000 ways for people to fall back into a life that led them to a spot where they didn't want to be. And it seems to me that providing other alternatives to allow people to start forward thinking again, thinking about what could be, what they want to do proactively, is the right step to take.
Election administrators like bright lines and clear standards. The current laws on eligibility to vote of former felons are not clear. We tell people to call the Department of Corrections to determine their eligibility. As Representative Simmons noted, passing this bill would change an unclear standard to a very clear one in which a potential registrant can determine their eligibility by answering one question. I would ask, are you confined by the Department of Corrections? If you are, I can't register you now. If you are not, you're eligible to register and vote.
I left prison 14 years ago, but it's taken over a decade for me to be able to openly share my identity as a formerly incarcerated person due to the discrimination and collateral consequences those of us with conviction histories face as we try to reenter society and rebuild our lives.
I was released to my community in March of 2014, but not in the way that you would think. I was paying taxes, buying bus passes, supporting my community, and paying bills like rent and utilities, but I was not able to vote while in work release.
We support this bill, and it's in alignment with the agency's mission to improve safety by positively changing lives. That's our whole mission in the department. Creating pathways to restore voting rights helps formerly incarcerated individuals feel connected to the community and allows them to use their voice in the political process. With approximately 26,000 individuals on community supervision and those housed in our work release facilities, the department and its staff are charged with a successful transition and reentry of individuals back into our communities.
Regarding deterrence, you know, I'm formerly incarcerated myself. I can't even fathom the idea of, say, being en route to rob a bank or something like that, and then someone in the car saying, you know what, we may not be able to vote if we go through with this. So we should just call it off. There's no deterrent effect. It's, as we've already learned, this is rooted in Jim Crow, rooted in a lot of post-slavery regulations that were designed to suppress the vote. And it's something that we need to end in Washington.
This bill is a top criminal justice and racial justice priority for the ACLU. It will remove barriers and expand access to democracy for many.
Our support is twofold. We believe in the policy, and we also believe it resolves any legal uncertainties in our current system. Data shows that people of color are overrepresented in the prison system. Currently, Black males are 6 times more likely to be incarcerated than white males. And in Washington State in 2020, Black Americans represented 17.9% of our inmate population, despite only being 4.4% of our state's population.
There is no legitimate criminal justice goal served by denying the right to vote. It will not make anyone safer. Second, I want to address the misguided calls we've heard in the past for carve-outs for certain offenses. The criminal legal system already accounts for the severity of one's crime during sentencing. People with more serious convictions spend more time in prison, but everyone who is on community supervision has been deemed to fit to live and work among us. And we should respect that determination and encourage reintegration and rehabilitation.
Thank you for watching the Daily Legislative Report by MLT News, covering the 2021 legislative session.